Okay, this is another video on one of my customers' Nissan Maxima. I'm going to be replacing the brake pads, the brake rotors, and I'm going to do it properly, unlike the previous person. And I'm also going to be replacing the control arms and the tire run-ins because they are FUCKED. Now, just to let you know, my customer, Kenneth Beatty Jr. Yes, I'm giving you a shout out. He is a big person. And I love him. And I love his father. So let's get rid of all this shit about color. Go for the person. Not the color of their skin. All right, off my soapbox. Let's move on and get this thing done. I have squeezed this with a G clamp. Squeeze the pads right up. So the next thing to do is get this info off of here. Get this rather, what shall I say, worn out rotor and. Oh, look at this lovely tire rod end here that is a POS, and you know what that means. The same applies, and I don't know if I can get there. Yeah, I can't quite get there. But believe me, hang on. No, sorry, don't believe me. Let me take this thing off my head. Sorry, guys, you're a bit upside down there. This ball joint here, as you can see, is split to fuck. It's crap. So that's got to come off. The joint there's got to come out. And I got to remove this panel to get to it. And then we'll get this caliper off. And we'll make this thing a darn sight safer than it really is. We will grease up these lug nuts. And we'll grease up these pads, and we're going to make this thing really nice and tight on the front end. And guys, you know what it's like to have a woman tight on the front end. I can't afford them now because I'm married, but you guys can, so get out there and do it. But when they say no, stop. Sorry, my little, what should I say? I can't even think of the word. Don't do it, girls. Guys. Girl says no, stop. Girl says no and teasing you, that's her problem. You keep going, you're in big shit. All right, enough of that crap. Let's get back to the work and the real shit. All right, not sure how good video content's going to be here. I'll do the best I can, but please understand I'm trying to do this and I cannot see what the content is. First thing you've got to do, once you've pressed the caliper back using your G clamp, and believe me, that's one of the best ways to do it, it just gets it out of the way, then you need to remove these bolts. Now, normally, the pins, these things, they will stay relatively still and you can undo the bolts without too much trouble. Now, I could be using a ratchet one on this to make it quicker, but I figured I'd just keep you guys hanging around and then, you know, you could have some fun, you could talk to your girl about cars and. All right, okay, it's not true. I've taken the bottom one out. Not sure if you can see that. Hopefully, not too bad a problem. Then take the top one out. Not too bad, but I'm going to replace them with new ones. So it don't matter. Take this off. Caliper's not looking too bad. Seal's looking okay. Got a little bit more squeezing to do to get it back before I put it on. Let me, excuse me, I'm sorry, I'm blinding you guys a bit there. I just want to tuck it up here of the way safely. All right, now let's have a look at these pads. Ooh, pretty bad. Rotors are shot. There's no two ways about that. Pad again, shot. These are, I don't know what you want to call them, anti-rattle pieces. They should always be replaced whenever you do a brake job. If you don't, you're an asshole. They're hard to get out sometimes. They're trash. If they don't come with the kit of the brake pads you've purchased, well, buy them separately. This one's got a few extra ears on it. That goes on the top. These pins should move in and out easily. That one does. Ooh, oh, and that one does too. On the other side, they didn't. So you've got to make sure they move in and out. I have ordered new kits for this because I want to make sure everything for this customer is as good as it can be. This guy doesn't hang around when he drives. I want to make sure when he sits that piece of shit in the road, he can stop. And I'll do my damnedest to help him. I can't help his driving, but I sure as hell can help the fact that the car he drives that I have fixed is as good as I can make it. So I've got new pins, I've got new bolts, I've got new rubber bushes, I've got new rotors, I've got new pads. There ain't much more than that. Okay, next I'm gonna take the cradle off. And no point in showing you that. You undo two bolts and take it off. Then I'm going to move on to taking out the control arm. That I will show you. So let me get this piece of shit out of the way. Get this crappy rotor out of the way. Oh my God, look at the ridge on that. Get this crappy rotor out of the way. And then get onto the control arm. So give me a second. We'll be back on the control arm. All right, this is an addition I wasn't going to put out there. To remove this cradle, you need a 19 millimeter wrench and a big ass motherfucking hammer. Big ass motherfucking hammer? Why? Because you're going to be hitting your most treasured wrench. But believe me, this is the easiest and best way to crack this MFSOB. Here we go. Are you ready? Can you see it? All right, there you go. She's cracked. That's one. Let's do number two. There we go. Okay, so those two are now loose. In fact, they are so loose, I can do it with my fingers. Come on, girls, I can do it with my fingers. You don't like my humor? Oh, well, tough shit. Here we go. And give me a second, and I'll be able to show you. Oop, don't lose the washer. There is no sealant on that. That is not so good. Don't worry, when it goes back on, it'll have some thread locker on it. Last thing you want is your brake caliper coming off when you hit that mother, because that asshole in front of you suddenly decided to pull across and he didn't know what he was doing. And oh my God! Now, of course, it could be the man in blue with his lights on behind you, and you better stop, otherwise, it could be bad. And we don't want that. Do what he says. Be quiet. Shut up. And let's move on. All right, there we go. Okay. Yep. Neither of those bolts had any thread locker on them. It surprises me, but maybe it's from the manufacturer. These are working good, so they just need a cleanup and a replacement, which is what I'm going to do right now. And before I go too far, let me show you. This is how to remove a rotor. Just like that. Oh. And if those of you... No, you're American. You wouldn't understand. It was a British comedian. He was called Tommy Cooper. And his catchphrase was... Oh. Yep, stupid, but there you go. All right, see this? See this rust here? You don't want that, again, because that bonds the rotor to the stub axle. So, you grab yourself. I use this grease. It's called copper grease. I'm not sure whether you can get it over here. I'm pretty sure you can. I buy it in tubs, and I get my son to send it to me from England. Why do I do this? Well, excuse me. I used to work in a car shop in England during my downtime from information technology, and they always use this copper grease. Copper grease is great. It's grease and it's copper. Copper is a natural lubricant, and it helps prevent corrosion with two different materials coming together. Yes, now I know the rotor is steel and steel. That's fine. But you can also use it between steel and aluminium or aluminum. And I smear it over the studs. Because then it stops the lug nuts, studs, wheel nuts, from bonding. It doesn't prevent them from holding, it just stops them from making a bit of a mess. All right, next is to get that goddamn control arm off. I hope you're ready for it, because I'm going to go down south to do it. And I'm... Jesus, you can't trust people, can you? Oh dear. It looks like somebody screwed up my nut on this side too. I'm going to have to grind it off. All right, back in a minute. Don't go away. Not like you can, because you're so excited. All right. It's not going to be possible for me to film what has to be done. So let me show you. I have to take the split pin out of there and then remove that nut. On the other side, the nut was so badly buggered by some asshole that I had to grind it off. I'm hoping that doesn't happen this side. You also need to remove that nut there, because we are replacing the control arm. So that's got to come off, and that's got to come off. Next, you need to make sure you remove this. If you're not replacing the tie rod end, you don't give a shit. I'm replacing the tie rod ends here because they are so bad. I have yet to douse this in PB Blaster, but I will do. Then, underneath, and I'm trying to show you, those two bolts need to come out. Again, they will be soaked with PB Blaster. And that little baby there, again, will be soaked with BB Blaster. So those are the ones that have got to come out. Unfortunately, because of what I got to do, it's not easy, and I can't really show you it, but do understand that's what needs to be done. So I'm going to take them out now, and I can tell you, once you've undone these two bolts here, and you have removed this nut here, and you have separated this ball joint here, you slide the control arm forward, of course, making sure that that's also off, slide the control arm forward, and it comes off really easily. Now, when you put it back together, to be nice to other prospective mechanics, put some grease on it. Give it some... I use copper grease. It's my thing. You do what you like. But something to prevent the metal surfaces bonding together. I'm gonna crack this nut here and take it all apart. Oh, sorry, you probably didn't get that. I'm gonna crack this nut here on the tie rod end, take this baby off here, and there you go. The sequence, I've said this so many times, the sequence of taking it apart, it's like in a Firkin Haynes manual. Once you've taken it apart, just put it back together. Yeah, and it's not that simple, but really that's what you got to do. Okay, this, as you can see, is already covered in copper grease, ready for the new ba 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 rotor. And don't forget to clean them before you put them on with brake cleaner. Otherwise, you're going to fuck up your brake pads, and you don't want to do that, because you know that customer D's going to get real pissed. And I don't know why I'm putting on such a silly accent, but it's fun. What the hell? Hey guys, you gotta have fun in life. All right, any questions regarding this particular job? Please email me. Please feel free to. It's gstargarage@gmail.com, and that is GSTARRR at gmail.com. And I would really appreciate it if you guys went onto my channel and subscribe to JagVet1. You don't have to watch my shit, just subscribe, it helps. JAGVETTE1. JagVet1. I don't get anything for it, but I just like to build my subscribers. All right, this one's coming out there, boys. Hope it helps you. Right, one of the other things to do when you're doing the brakes as well on this particular vehicle, always make sure you get these nice and clean and that these slide in and out easily. My favorite lubrication of choice is copper grease. That way it doesn't bond to anything. And just push it on and we're done. Look at that. Beautiful. Doinky, 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 and two new bolts with them. The pads the customer got from AutoZone, Duralast C-Max, they're good pads. My only gripe is they don't come with the hardware kit, or these springs. They must be replaced at the same time. And when I'm putting these pads in, I like to just put a little light bit of grease on these ends and obviously on the back here. The kit does come with a grease. So, you know, if you're not like me and have tubs of copper grease everywhere, then use this grease. It's not bad, not bad at all. And I would always suggest that if it is a vehicle you're keeping, buy the most expensive pads you can afford. At AutoZone, they are lifetime warranty, which means when they run out or wear out, you take them back and they give you another set for free. So you only ever have to buy them once for your vehicle. For them, it's what's called a lost leader. In other words, you'll go in there and you'll buy other stuff. That's the theory, and to be honest, it does quite often work. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is disconnect the tie rod. So, to do that, you will need a trusty 22 mm and a 13 mm. 13 to hold the shaft. Whoops, hello, my light just went dim. Rather like me, I know. Hang on a second, I'm going to plunge you into darkness. There we go. All right, and holding it, and what I do is I rest it up against the. Let's see if I can brighten that up. I rest it there against the bracket, and then. Oh, there you go, that one went quite easily. All right, and what I'll do is I'll just leave it right in that position. That way, when the customer picks up the vehicle and takes it before it's the alignment is done, the alignment's not too far off. That's the theory. Now, once we've done that, I've already removed the... Oh, hang on a second. That is so bright. I've already removed the nut on this side. So now I've got to get my trusty tool. Where is my trusty tool? Hello, trusty. Ah, there it is. This little beastie. But one minor thing, I need the airline. Bear with me whilst I go and get my airline. I'll take that off of there too. Have a walk around. Okay. Of course, I threw the airline there. It was on the floor. You know, I really would be dangerous at half a brain cell. You see, it was already here. It was on my gun. Pow. Now, this is going to get noisy. There she blows. I tell you, if you've got a compressor, that's a great thing to have. It makes this job so much easier. Okay, now all I have to do is take that end off of there. Hopefully it'll come off relatively easily. Look, yeah, there you go. The light on this is okay. Ah, I didn't put plasters on my cuts. Now I'm grinding grease into my cuts. You love working on cars. Cuts, blisters, scrapes. All the fun things. And then, of course, the wife gets pissed at you. But, as I often say, my wife says if I come out of this garage and I'm not bleeding, then I haven't been doing anything. I've just been sitting watching the TV. Can't say I haven't ever done that. Now, one thing I'm going to show you in a second, as soon as I can get this off. See this? This is the gyro lens. That's not good for your steering. That's a garbage. Then you grab your trusty new one. There you go. With its nice new castle nut and split pin. Oh no, this one's got a, I lied to you, this has got a Nylock on it. That's fine, Nylock's okay. They work. And just screw it on right up to the nut. Is that better? I'd have given that some thought. There we go. And I'll pinch that up once I've got it back in. One thing I will do is give that a quick wire brush. Now I'm not going to put it back in yet because I'm going to be replacing the lower ball joint. It's easier. Actually, I'm going to do that from the front. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, that just missed my foot again. Oh, I'm glad I caught that. Oh boy, that was pretty dumb. You see, I put my mistakes in the video as well. And for those of you watching where I said, wow, just missed my foot, look at that. That's how it landed. That could have been that heavy bit on my flippy flop toe. You can bet your life the air would have gone blue then. Woo-wee, man. Alright, let me get the nut off of that and then separate that joint and show you how to remove the lower control arm. And those of you that are sharp-eyed, notice this is covered in copper grease now. So when I put the new rotor on there, if the next guy comes along and needs to change it, it won't be bonded rusty to the hub, so he'll have an easier job. I like to do things like that for other people. Hey, it may even be me that's doing it, who knows? But It's always nice to be nice. And I don't do nice that often, so... Here we go. All right, let me get the tools and get this control arm off, but I will show you how it's done. Well, someone has been here previously, whoever it was that put this nut on, burred the edges of the nut, so consequently the wrench doesn't fit it. What I'm going to have to do is the same as I did on the other side, and that is I'm going to have to grind that off. I won't film me grinding it because, apart from being bloody noisy, it's not really that interesting. So I'm going to have to grind that nut off, then I can separate the ball joint. And also you have to take out the drop link there, sway bar link, in order to get the control arm out. Okay, that's it for the moment. Back in a second when we will be removing this nut and separating the ball joint from the hub. Okay, here we are. I have now ground one side of the nut away, and I doubt you can see it, but I can actually see that I've gone in deep enough and I can see the pitch where the threads are. Now it's a matter of getting a persuader and a chisel and whacking it on one side to unscrew what's left of the nut. I did touch the little hub there, but that's okay. That's just a couple of little scars. It's not going to cause any problems. And do note, when you put this back together, and I'll show you, that you do have to put the ball joint in and then put the nut on, because of where the CV axle shaft is, the nut won't come off. So what I'm going to do, and I'll video it, but it'll be damn noisy, is once I've got this nut loosened and right up as high as I can get it to go, then I'm going to attack the ball joint with my trusty fork separator. So let me attack this nut first of all, and then we'll be back. Wished I could have filmed that. It took one tap, and as you can see, the nut has spun, and now I should be able to just undo that with probably even a pair of pliers, because obviously the nut itself is kind of destroyed. So let me get that nut as high up as I can. For those of you that are curious as to what I used, I actually used a cutting wheel, not a grinder wheel. It's thinner, and for me it's more precise. I prefer to use that kind of wheel when I'm doing this sort of work. And I've mentioned it in previous videos, and no, I don't get paid, as I often have to say, but this is a great little tool, this cordless DeWalt grinder. It is absolutely amazing. I wish I'd discovered one of these before. And as I've mentioned before, it was my friend that discovered these. He bought one and loved it so much he bought me one. That's a friend. That's a real friend. I mean, hell, who's going to do that? So anyway, rechargeable batteries, it's terrific. So now the thing to do is to get the separator and fork in separate it. One moment. Alright, just a couple of things. I got a bit out of order there. I'm not going to take this ball joint off just this moment. I want to take off this sway bar link first. And those of you that have got sharp eyes will have seen this piece of string hanging down. I tied the brake caliper up there out of the way. I know some people use like a bungee kind of cord. I don't like those. Why? Well, because they're not that adjustable. A piece of string is very adjustable. That's just my preference. You go do what you go do. Right, now let's see. And this is a 14 millimeter, by the way. There is a nut on this side, which you do have to hold. Okay, stand by for the noise. As you can see, that baby got hot. Those threads are tight. Hoo-hoo. Smoking gun. I'm going to move that, but I ain't going to touch it for a minute. What I am going to do now is go over to my next little tool, which is this little beastie here. Another really noisy tool. This adapter here, I got that, yeah, from Harbour Freight. The nuts are smoking. Oh, my nuts are smoking too, baby. Okay. Just can't take this guy anywhere. So let us see now if it will separate this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the flat edge here, rather than the angled edge, up against the bottom of the hub. Now, are we ready? Time for some more noise. And there she blows. For those of you that have a compressor, I strongly recommend you get this tool if you haven't got it, and get that fork for when you're doing this kind of work. It makes life so much firking easier. That is now separate. That's beautiful. What I got to do now is just take that little piece of nut off. Okay, and that I can do with my fingies. There. Off. And separate it. Look at that. Beautiful. Now we're going to undo is... That's all, folks. No, sorry. Wrong channel. Is to undo the nuts underneath. So let me get underneath. I promise, girl, it'll be good. To remove this control arm, there are three bolts. This one, none of those, and this one. This one here on the end is a 27 mil, and these are 22 mil. And obviously I'm going to be using my impact wrench. So, let me see if I can get this camera in the right place. There you go. Hopefully that'll... Oh, now that's in the way, isn't it? Okay, guys, hang on. Yeah, okay, Unfortunately, it does mean that you might see my face. Sorry. Also, it does mean I need to find the gun. Oh, there it is. Excited by watching me do this. I'm quite excited myself. As Jeremy Clarkson would say, I'm nursing a semi. Nice one, Jeremy. Alright, let's see. I don't know if I can get my gun in here. Nah, I cannot get my gun in there. Oh, bottom. Alright, so that's stopped me doing that particular one. I'll have to get a... just a breaker bar on it, I think. Alright, so let's have a go at these two over here. Are we ready? Nice and easy. And when these go back in, they go back in with Loctite. Blue. Look at that. Sweet as a nut. Now, where is my breaker bar? Breaker bar. I got my short little half. Nothing like a short half. Or a short ass. Short ass? Okay, let's move you back here. Don't know if this is going to work, because this is a very short wrench. I might have enough strength, but we'll see. Okay. We'll see that I probably don't. No, I don't. All right, I've got to get my breaker bar on this. I'll be back. Here we go with the breaker bar. I'm sure you all heard that. I told you that motherfucker was tight. Okay, good. Now, I've broken it with the breaker. Breaking it with the broker. Can use me ratchet. Because it's quicker. Oh, I just knocked the camera. Oh, and I see that block of view. Sorry, guys. There you go. Me undoing a nut. How exciting.
Cha-cha-cha.
And there's only one reason I'm keeping this going. Actually, let me move you guys over here. Another volume. Is it good? It's a bit wonky picture. Damn it. You know, I gotta buy some more equipment, I guess, to make proper videos. And if this bit doesn't come out well, it doesn't come out. Big ass nut. Everything is now disconnected from this, and it just slides off. Let's see. There she is, with its knackered ball joint. All right, we have a full replacement for this. Let me grab the camera again. Move you guys around a bit. And see, that shaft is dry. That should never be dry. But manufacturers are like that. So I will give that a bit of a clean. And slap her up with copper grease. And reassemble everything. Wow. Don't think, as usual, you really need me to show you how to put back what you have taken off. That should be pretty simple. I might show you with the brakes just what I do with regards to greasing up, etc. But the control arm, you know, you slide it back on the way. I just took that one off and put the nuts and bolts in. There you go. All right. Time to cut this one off. Right. Let's see how this goes. Got the new cross member control arm here. That's going to grease up my shaft. Okay, I do like to grease up my shaft before I start. Makes things go so much easier. All right, now it's real easy. hang on a second, I'm going to move. Why? Because otherwise I will knock it over. Okay. And this just it just slips on there. Once you get it lined up anyway, it does. And just push her on. The do-run-run. Okay, there she goes. Look at that. Beautiful. Right, I'm just going to slip the nut on here for the moment. And I will be putting a thread locker on there, but I'm only going to put it on, you know, let's say the initial half inch here. There's no point in putting it anywhere else, you're just wasting it. So now I've got to get these two bolts and make sure they line up. Let me see if I can make sure this one lines up first. Yes, it does. Great. That's terrific. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get up and go and shut up that idiot that's talking in the background. Excuse me, don't go away. Enjoy staring at what the hell it is you're staring at. Stop staring. You know that's my voice. Alright, there we go. Somebody once said, the older you get, every movement comes with a noise. Some of them come with noises and other things that you don't want. You know, like a fart. I believe it was in, what was the movie? The Bucket List, where Jack Nicholson said, there were, I think it was three things. Never pass up a bathroom. Never trust a fart. And there was something else, and I can't remember what it was. All right, so we've got a bit of thread liquor on there. Thread liquor. I like the liquor. Hang on, that doesn't feel quite right.
this is the last time. The last thing you want to do is screw up one of these threads. You'll be a shit creek without a paddle, that's for sure. Let me try this side. See if this one's aligned a little better. Yeah, that one's going in good. Alright. Where is my wrench? There it is. And I need my socket. I'm not going to do this with the air gun because I want to feel it. I want to make sure that I'm not getting cross-threaded. For those of you that think I'm anal about this, go ahead. You do it your way, I do it mine. I bet I have less problems than you do. Well, apart from, you know, those kind of problems. Alright, there we go. That's looking good. Alright. Next. Okay, who stole my thread locker? Hello. Oh, it's there. It's right under my fucking nose. Dumb shit. Alright. Let's make sure we get this one in correctly. Feels good. Let's see if it is good. Wrong. That is wrong. There's something wrong there. Oh no, no. We do not do that. Just not quite aligned. Yeah, okay, yes. Alright, my little baby. Let's see if that does it better. This is the advantage of not tightening everything up first. Good. Where's that light? Excuse me, guys. I have seen the light.
You're right. Oh, I see. Wow. The thread on this bolt is buggered. That obviously happened when the previous mechanic did some work here. All right, so I'm now going to have to clean this off and get my die on here and re-tap this thread properly. I do not want to screw this up. So, just going to take you off the air now, guys. And then I'll be back to do this final bolt. Okay, I finally managed to get that thread cleared and put in. So now it's just a matter of some Loctite on here. There we go. Little dab of the blue juice. Now, let's spin this up. That is my wrench, there it is. Now, I will be doing final torquing on these once I have the weight on the vehicle. Otherwise, you could end up tearing these bushes. So I'm just bringing it up close. And then, once I've got the vehicle back on its feet, then I'll come underneath here and tighten these off. Okay. Just want to let you know that. All right. And something I do, which is entirely up to you guys, is I often get a piece of blue tape, stick it on the driver's door, and I write on it things that I must remember to do. In other words, tightening this nut. You know, if I drop a socket and can't find it, find the socket. All those kind of things. Often a good aid memoir, as they say. Especially when you're an old fart like me, and you kind of forget shit sometimes. But there you go. All right. I promised you break stuff, didn't I? All right. Let's get this final ball joint in. Ah, shit. I'll show you that too. Give me a second. Right. I'm grabbing my trusty air jack here. Now time to line this up. And I mentioned before, there we go, you gotta get the nut on before you get too far. So let's get some threads through. Oop, it's misaligned. Down. Here, see, there's a step on it, and you gotta get it right. Let's try again. Oop. That's a little too far. Okay. Now I should be able to get this nut on. Oh, before I do that, let me check which way the hole is. It's front to back, and I don't like that. I prefer it sideways. I wonder if maybe I can change that. Don't go away. Keep watching. Now, because I want my hole in a different position, or in a different hole, ooh, that's naughty. Gonna take this out. Oh, my light just went dim. Rather like me. So let me see if I can, with my spike. Ah, there we go. I just wanted to turn that. Hopefully you can see that, even though the light dimmed. I just wanted to turn it so the hole's this way. That way it's a lot easier for me to get a split pin in there. Or as you guys call them, a collar pin. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Missed again. It's picky, but it's lovely with this air jack because it's so quick and simple. Rather like me. Quick and simple, huh? Let's try again. Obviously, guys, you don't have to have an air jack. You can do it with a normal jack. Or a Susan. Or a Jane. Or a Stephen, if that's your preference. Sure as hell ain't mine, but hey, each to their own. Whatever floats your boat. No, I haven't quite got enough in yet. That's what she always says. Not quite enough in yet. That's all I got. There are limits, you know. Yes, I'm disgusting. This is the disgusting channel. And occasionally we throw out naughty jokes. Just for shits and giggles. Now in this sunny climate of Black Lives Matter and all of that, let me tell a joke that is regarding people of colour. Oh, no, you mustn't say colour, you have to say black. Which is kind of odd, because across the pond, you mustn't say black, you have to say coloured. Unless that's changed, of course, that was a while since I'd been there. Anyway, it was a fancy dress party. And this black person turns up, stark naked, with his dick in a bowl of custard. And the hostess says, "What the hell are you meant to be?" He says, "I'm fucking disgusted." Oh, come on, guys, it's funny. It's a joke. Don't take it personal. I can't get me nuts on. Me nut don't want to go on. Why don't me nut want to go on? It did before I stuck it in the hole. That sounds interesting. Oh, there she goes. All right. That's good. Now, you got to get that nut on before you volume it up like this. All right. There we go. Hopefully you guys can see that. So the nut is on. Now all you need to do is tighten it up. In fact, what I probably would do, in all honesty to you guys, is that's kind of got the weight on it now. So I'm going to tighten up that other nut. So we're good to go. Two nuts to tighten, then it's on to the brakes. Having grabbed your new brake rotor, you will discover, and if you don't discover it, then naughty naughty, once you get this baby out of here, it has actually got a coating on it to stop it from rusting. You need to take that off before you put your rotor on, because it will destroy your pads. This is what brake clean was really meant for. Now, I always do this side first, because then when I flip it over, I'm not resting the rotor back onto a surface that could possibly have some grease on it. Doesn't need much cleaning, just a good old squirt, and boy, does that touch stink. Then grabbing it in the middle, flip it over, and do the other side. Now you can see that the surface is not touching the box anymore, therefore I'm not contaminating it. Grease and brakes are not a good mixture. Even though you do put it on here, you don't put it on the pads themselves. All right, now we just get this baby up here and chunk her on. Throw this on the floor, ready for later. Now, one thing I like to do, and again, not everybody does it, so you know, you've got to do your own shit. I've got to put the caliper back on, because I've got to put the, sorry, you're not seeing that. Because I've got to put the caliper back on, it's awkward if this is flopping around. And some vehicles have screws that hold it. This one doesn't. What a surprise. So I just grab one of the lug nuts, or even wheel nuts if you prefer, which I do, but there you go. When in Rome, you know, you're in America, speak American. That's my thoughts. I lived in Germany for a while. I learnt German. Okay, so the nut is now holding that in place. I can now begin to reassemble the caliper and the rest of the stuff. So, let me... I'm going to turn the camera off and then back on again. Not that you'll notice. All right, time to put the caliper back on, and these are the two bolts here. So let's blow them up. Well, at least one of them. And just get this in here. Okay, that's gone on nicely. There we go. And there's okay, a little bit on the bottom one. And as I've mentioned before, guys, I use blue, not red, Red is really hard. I mean, those are for things that you don't think you're ever going to take off again, whereas this is something that is likely to be taken off again. So let's get this good and tight. Not sure what size, I believe it's a 19. Let's find out. Yes, there we go. It's a 19, okay. And let's get these good and tight, as the Germans would say, good and tight. And with that thread locker, these mofos, they ain't going nowhere. Even if they wanted to, they're not. Alright. Oops. Alright. So, that's those locked on. Now, next thing I gotta do. Okay, somebody stole me cotton bud. Well, that's not very nice. I was here a moment ago. What happened to that bugger? That's what happened, it stuck on me. Okay, so get yourself some grease. I use copper grease. And I just rub it on the back where the pistons are going to touch it. Now, this is a single piston caliper. So the center area is the most important. And then I just put a little dab, not too much, don't go crazy, because you don't want to get on the rotors. Just where the metal's going to touch the metal. All right, so then you grab one of these and stick it in the hole. Oops, hang on, wrong way around. There we go, one in. Oh, excuse me. Now, note on the outer pad, it actually rubs on the two outer points, not in the center. So you don't need to put it in the center. You can if you want, but it's just kind of a waste. And so, there we go, with a little bit more grease here and here, where the metal touches metal. You don't really want to get it on that scraper, because that scraper, or squealer, sorry, not scraper, it's a squealer, touches the rotor. And hope you like Queen. It's being broadcast at the moment, which is great. Kind of miss Freddie. Never met him, of course, but what a talented individual. All right, now again with some blue, just to get the caliper on there. You don't have to do it. I just like to. It just kind of makes me feel good that it's not going to come out easily. So grab your caliper, slip it over, push in these pins, and I know you can't really tell, but they do move nice and easy, those pins. Well, it doesn't move nice and easy as me. And you need to spin the flanges, because there are flanges on these pins, and you need to get them in the right place. Not always easy, I grant you. In fact, excuse me one second, guys. Yeah, but yeah, I need to turn that one. Almost there. Alright, what's the bottom one doing? You have to line these babies up. There we go. Okay, we just spin these up. That's good. That's it, and the top one's lined up now as well. Once you get them lined up, it's nice and easy. They just drop into position. So, you know, if you're having trouble, don't try forcing it. It's not going to work. And as my mum used to say, a man forced his pig and he died. And that's a culinary term, so you guys will probably have to look that one up. I'm going to leave it there. Man forced his pig and it died. Google it. Alright. Oops, that's the wrong size. Right, there we go, that's a 14. I don't know if I mentioned it before, but that is a 14 millimeter. So that's the caliper back on. The control arm's done. Everything is tightened up. Everything's looking absolutely sweet. Next is to take this baby for a test drive, smoke the tires, drive it like it should be driven. I'm sure the customer does that. He's a young guy, and I'm sure he don't hang around. Just don't get caught, my friend. Police kind of frown upon it, so do it somewhere safe, eh? Now, why the fuck should you listen to me? Just an old fart. What do I know? I've only been around 70 years. Okay, there we are, boys. It is done. The car is done, apart from me putting